Hi everyone, I'm Ulrich, this is Tarek. We're just going to do a little pec loosening combo. Using equipment you'd find in the gym, it's extremely effective. Let's go. I've got Tarek just simply in what we call the crook lying position. We are going to be targeting the tightness in his chest, often from pec minor, deep inside the front of his chest, but also pec major, the more obvious muscle that'll sit over the top of the pec minor. My first bit of kit that's so useful is a kettlebell, and especially this handle part. It's got a great shape for actually doing a bit of your own myofascial release on your clients. Just make sure you don't hit the bony parts of his shoulder. You've got to go into that sort of valley of soft tissue. Make sure that hand is nicely relaxed in that open position. Add a little bit of pressure. Just check that he's reasonably comfortable with that. You don't want to push so hard that you scare him off. Okay, both knees together, Tarek. Let's do that little rotation thing. And once he gets to kind of that tightness limit, as long as I'm doing my job properly and actually holding that shoulder down, he can do like 10 to 20 reps just pulsing like this. Now, if you were to talk to a massage therapist, they might call this something quite fancy, like an active release technique. Yeah, whatever you call it. It's really effective for opening up this hole we call anterior oblique chain, certainly primarily through in that pec minor, pec major area. Really works to open up that shoulder. One more little set of five, mate. Just, that's right, relax into it, opening up that chest. I'm making sure the shoulder doesn't rise. All right, so there's one technique. You probably do another minute or two of it in your own time, come back to zero. Right, so our second little technique here for this pec combo is not with a kettlebell, it's with some sort of sandbag or power bag. And this is what we call a contract relax technique. It's a PNF idea and works really nicely after you've done a little bit of that trigger point sort of work. Keep his knees up, right, stops the spine moving too much. Then we open the shoulder and just relax him here. Just, this is not at all uncomfortable even, this particular technique. Just check that he can't rotate his spine too much. We're going to lay this power bag gently on here and get him to do some just push and pull, if you like. So as long as he's not too uncomfortable in the lower back or anything, once we get to the limit there of that mobility he has, I want him to push gently for a count of five. That's right. So we kind of count down for him. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then relax, Tarek. Beautiful. Let's that chest go. It stretches a little bit further. You can gently help him to relax into it. See, I'm using the power bag to get that lovely big kind of chest opening. One more little hold, that's it. 5 seconds holding and then relax for me. 5 seconds kind of breathing and stretching. Really, it's amazing how much range of motion you can get prior to some sort of pull work or any sort of postural challenge that you've got with a client. All right, so you probably do like 4 or 5 little sets of that. And that's really going to open up that chest for any kind of pull work you want to do with your client, or for those with all kinds of aches and pains in their necks, shoulders and back and stuff. All right, hope it works for you.